I'm back! After a week off with the entire company, we are now back with renewed energy, more Azure news, and a fresh supply of cloud jokes, and much more. I'm Lars Klint, and you are watching Azure This Week, a show squeezed out from the stratocumulus above your compute resources. This week, there is new fusion detection, a new way to connect to Azure for macOS, and some automation goodies. First though, I'd like to remind you to join our Discord server to discuss more of the Azures. At ACG, we love cloud, and on Discord, we talk about all the clouds, including Azure. So come on over, we're friendly. Ransomware. Ugh. One of the few things that can really bring a company to its knees in cyberspace, with an estimated cost of $20 billion in 2020. It can lock up critical systems, cause mayhem in supply chains, and decimate entire processes. In large organizations, an employee will invariably fall for the ransomware trap eventually, so it is critical that effective measures are in place. And cloud is no different. This week, Microsoft thought so too, and launched, wait for it, Fusion Detection. Yep, that's what they call it. At a high level, it is an aggregator for data from Azure Defender instances, Azure Sentinel, and Microsoft Cloud App Security. Fusion Detection will identify suspicious activity from IP addresses connecting to questionable endpoints, and even monitor suspicious PowerShell and command line actions. It detects brute force attacks, malware deployments, specific instances of ransomware, credential theft, and so much more. Fusion Detection is now publicly available, with alerts being surfaced through Azure Sentinel. Occasionally, just occasionally, features for Azure are announced that I was certain already existed, but they didn't. This week, the Azure VPN Client for macOS was released in general availability, and I was sure that was already a thing, but I guess not. In any case, the Azure VPN Client supports connection with native Azure AD, certificates, or RADIUS authentication for OpenVPN. With the Azure VPN Client for macOS, you can now use user-based policies, conditional access, as well as multi-factor authentication, or MFA, for your Mac devices. This will allow you to connect to a virtual network using point-to-site VPN and Azure Active Directory authentication in order to access Azure resources on that VNet. Neat. 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 Last, there are a bunch of updates coming soon to Azure Automation. These are features in development, but Microsoft are so excited about them, they want us to know. So ready? There's a new hybrid worker extension for Azure and Arc machines. This will provide seamless onboarding of Azure and non-Azure or Arc machines. Confusing. There's support for PowerShell 7. There's Azure AD authentication support for all automation service public endpoints. There's use of latest AZ modules in PowerShell runbooks by default. High reliability and resiliency to handle zone-wide outages with the use of availability zones. And all of these new features will bring automation runbooks up to speed with the rest of Azure and make them even more useful for everyday automations. Or is that automatons? Have you been a victim of ransomware? What happened and how did you solve the mess? Let us know in the comments. Also, if you want to keep up with Azure News, consider subscribing to the channel. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Yes. As we say on the A Cloud Guru team, after a week off that was spent looking at llamas and sorting 18 kilos of Lego, but now it is back to cloud computing goodness. Seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. I shouldn't eat nuts just before.